So this is the question that I guess I get asked all the time, which is how do you buy property at home? What are the actual steps involved? So I decided to do a video on it. So stay with me. If we haven't met before, my name is Natasha. I'm the founder of Diaspora Connect. And on this channel, I like to give you information and inspiration on the Zambian property market so that if you want to buy property back home, you can do so in a safe and reliable way. Now, I know you've been away for a long time, so maybe you have no idea about the process of buying land. You don't understand the process. Maybe you know patches of information here and there, but you haven't really been able to put it all together in your mind. So in this video, I'm going to take you through 7 key steps of how to actually buy property in Zambia. Now, I don't want to overload you with information because it'll be one long video that you're not going to watch. So as I said earlier, I'm going to break it up into 2 parts. So this first video is going to talk about the first 3 steps, and that's going to be 1, how do you check out the property to make sure it's actually a good investment, that you should buy this property. The second part is how do you make sure everything is in writing, because you need to have a property transaction in writing. And the third part will be you making your payments towards that property. So in part 2, I'm going to talk about what happens after you finish paying for the property all the way up to getting your title deeds. Because what I've seen a lot of is people buy a property, they finish paying for it, and they end there, but the process doesn't end there. And that's what I'm going to talk about in part 2. So like I said, I'm going to break down all the steps, but before I get started, there are 2 things I want to say. First of all, nothing in this video should be construed as legal advice. If you have a property that you do want to buy, then you need to engage a property professional or a licensed lawyer. And you know I'm both, right? The second thing I want to say is that if you want a summary of the whole process, then we have prepared an info sheet for you. So just click on the link in the description below this video, add your name and email address, and we will send our info sheet directly to your inbox. Okay, so let's get into it. Let's assume that you have found a great property, you really like it, and you're ready to buy. So like I said, the first step is you need to check out the property or do a due diligence, as we say. Now, you actually need to have somebody to go to site and look at the property physically. Now, I know, of course, you're not here, you are abroad. So this is where you can have a trusted family member or a trusted friend to check out the property for you. They can go to site, take pictures and take videos and send them to you. Now, we also know that a lot of people here are busy with their own lives. You have a goal that you want to achieve. You want to buy the property. And sometimes people here get busy. They're not exactly, you know, responding promptly to your messages or to your request to visit the site. So this is something that we often do for a lot of you abroad. We will actually go to site and we will take the pictures for you. We'll send you videos of what the place actually looks like. That is the physical due diligence. You also need to do a legal due diligence. And this is basically doing searches at public registries to make sure that the person who's selling the property actually owns the property. So the Lands and Deeds Registry keeps a database of all property that is on title. You need to do a search or have somebody do that search for you and confirm that this person is actually the owner. You can also do a similar search at Lusaka City Council to confirm who the owner of the property is. Now, this step is so important. This first step of checking out the property physically and legally. So make sure that you, like I said, you engage a professional to do it for you or somebody who you really trust to do it for you. But like I said, it's always best to use professionals because they understand the process and the procedures a lot better. And they're able to give you an informed opinion based on what those searches reveal. So step number 2, you've checked out the property, you like it, you've done your due diligence properly, or you've had someone do it for you. So now we get into putting the transaction in writing. This is the stage where you've decided to go ahead, you must have this transaction in writing. So make sure that you have a contract. And again, this is why it's so important to engage a lawyer. The contract is a very important document because it sets out what each party's obligations are. It'll set out exactly what it is you're buying. It'll say how you're going to pay for the property. And it'll also set out other important information and details relating to how you're going to buy the property. Now, sometimes if you're buying a property which is in a large development, so we do have commercial developers that will sell multiple units, you may find that they prefer to give you a letter of offer, and that's perfectly fine. Or you may find that you're on an extended payment plan and they would prefer to start you off with a letter of offer. And once you hit certain milestones in your payments, they're then comfortable to put everything down in a contract. But the important thing that I want to emphasize here is that it must be in writing of some sort. I have seen cases where people in the diaspora call me and they say, could you help me retrieve my money? I bought this property, and they have absolutely no paper trail. They have a few emails back and forth saying, oh, I sent some money, but there is no letter of offer. There's no contract. You don't want to fall into this trap. So the third step now is we're coming into making payments. You've gotten into a contract, you know what your obligations are in terms of how you're going to pay for the property, whether it's a lump sum, whether you're paying over several months or even several years. So now this is the stage where you're actually making those payments. In terms of the mechanism to use, what I hear a lot from you guys in the diaspora is that bank transfers and things like that can be quite expensive. And I totally agree. But it's just an unnecessary evil that we all have to deal with. I do know that there's some other payment mechanisms that a few of you use that I've come across. But what I would urge you is that whatever you use to transfer money, make sure it is reliable and it's not something that forces you to keep having to make follow-ups to make sure that the funds actually have arrived. And in this crucial third step, one of the other things that I would like to point out is make sure that you always get a receipt for your payments. And this is, again, something that I see people skipping out. So when you do make a payment, make sure that you retain your proof of payment, generate a proof of payment, send it to your vendor, and make sure they're able to give you a receipt. So those are the first three steps. And most people end there. So they've gotten into the contract, they've paid for the property, and they think, well, I'm done. I even know some people in the diaspora who will even start building on the property. And it's even local people as well. But you're not done. And in the next video, I'm going to talk about what happens after that. There's still four more steps to go until you get your title deed. And that is so important because that is conclusive evidence that only you own that property. So you don't want to stop at just paying for your property. All right, so like I said, in this short video, I just wanted to cover the first three steps, which was how do you check out the property? In other words, how do you do the due diligence? How do you make sure the transaction is in writing? And the third step is making payments for your property. In the next video, I'm going to complete the whole process. But like I said, if you would like a summary of the whole process, then download our info sheet. The link is in the description below this video. And let me know if you have found this first part useful. I really would like to know. Let me know if you also have any questions. But like I said, if you have a property that you're currently contemplating buying, then please ask a registered property professional for their advice. All right, guys, so I hope you found that informative. Give me a thumbs up if you did. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel because you don't want to miss part two or any other videos that we drop on this channel. And hit the notification button so that you don't miss any videos. Now, I know that for some of you, there might be other people in your communities where you are that are interested in property at home. So please share this video with them. And connect with us on social media because we love to chat with you there. If you'd like to contact us directly, then all of our contact details are in the description below the video. Otherwise, it's bye for now and we'll see you next time. Second step will be how to put everything in writing. Third part will be